In 1939, 835 sheep were killed during a thunderstorm in Pine Canyon, Utah. That's obviously super sad. But it's even worse when you realize I don't mean a bunch of thunderstorms spread all across all of 1939. I mean in a single moment of a single thunderstorm. 835 sheep were killed by a single bolt of lightning. It's safe to say this wasn't an act of Zeus or Thor or Sisyphus Telemann, but what really happened here? It turns out a classic bolt from the heavens is far from the only way you can get struck by lightning. And as those sheep learned, some of the ways can also be far more dangerous. Before we get into the story of the sheep, let's talk about what lightning even is. Earth's air normally acts as an electrical insulator. In other words, electrical charge has a hard time moving through it. So over time, due to little bits of things constantly moving around, you'll eventually get a difference in charge built up between the bottoms of clouds and the ground. Like, a patch of cloud gets super negative, and the ground below it, by comparison, is super positive. Once too much difference builds up, the atmosphere finds a way to discharge it all and reset the system. As you might suspect, the way it does that results in a lightning bolt. But the lightning bolt you see isn't the whole thing. Before the visible bolt strikes, it's preceded by a bunch of invisible trails of ionized air called leaders that start up in the clouds and quickly creep downward on the hunt for the best path to take to the ground. Meanwhile, trails of air with the opposite charge called streamers travel upward from the ground, and objects just chilling out on the ground. Each of these trails represents a possible path the eventual discharge can take. And wherever a leader slash streamer pair connects, that's where the visible lightning bolt appears. Now, since lightning is looking for the shortest path between the ground and the atmosphere, it does tend to strike the tallest thing around, but not always. Lightning can strike a shorter object if it's closer to the lightning's source, and also if there just so happens to be a taller column of ionized air over its head. Basically, the streamer shooting up from your head gets an advantage, which for you would wind up being a major disadvantage. A lot of lightning also just hits the ground. About 8 million lightning strikes hit the ground every day. While that stat might make you want to hide in your nearest basement, let me reassure you, your odds of getting hit by lightning in a given year are less than 1 in 1 million. And assuming you're human, you're not very likely to get killed if you do get struck by lightning. 90% of all lightning strike victims survive, although you may have to deal with some pretty bad side effects. Plus, not all lightning strikes are created equal. The US's National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, better known as NOAA, has classified up to 5 different types of lightning strikes, all of which can be dangerous. The one you're probably imagining is the direct strike. This is when lightning actually hits an object head on. If you were to get struck by lightning this way, some of the discharge would go along your skin, causing burns, and some would go through your body, which is even worse. But while that sounds terrible, this is not the most common way to get struck by lightning. Even if you're relatively close to the bolt, it could miss you entirely. Although even those near misses can still be deadly. For an example, let's look at an animal you might think has a way greater chance of getting struck by lightning than a human, the giraffe. If you've heard that giraffes are like 30 times more likely to be killed by a lightning strike than a human, just know that that is based on a very small sample size. In 2020, 2 giraffes in South Africa were found dead after a lightning storm. Due to the damage to the taller giraffe's skull, it was obvious it had been directly struck. But the other giraffe's body, which was found about 7 meters away, had no visible signs of damage. Somehow the lightning still managed to get to her. We'll get back to exactly how later. The second way you can get struck by lightning has to do with those streamers I mentioned earlier. Every lightning bolt comes with multiple streamers, and sometimes even when the streamer over your head hasn't officially been chosen, it can still discharge. That means you can get hit by lightning even if the main bolt struck some distance away. Next, there are side flashes. These are why you're not supposed to seek shelter under a tree during a thunderstorm. Even though the tree might be taller than you, if it happens to get struck by lightning, a portion of the current could jump from the tree across a bit of air and into you. That's because lightning is always looking for the most convenient path to the ground. path of least resistance kind of stuff. And the human body is a lot less resistant to the flow of electricity than a tree trunk. Our penultimate type of lightning strike is called conduction, and it's why you're not supposed to shower during a thunderstorm. Metal, water, and other good electrical conductors are easy paths for lightning to take. So if lightning happens to strike your water pipes while you're showering, you could still get electrocuted. Something similar happened to 6 unfortunate cows in Australia back in 2018, who were all found dead, lined up in a row at a barbed wire fence. The farmer originally thought they'd been poisoned, but the most likely scenario is that the fence got struck by lightning somewhere and the current got carried however far sideways until it went through the cows. And before we get into the 5th type of lightning strike, all science needs funding, so here is an ad. This SciShow video is supported by Jump, the statistical analysis software trusted by the largest pharmaceutical companies, consumer products companies, and semiconductor companies in the world. Consumer product companies rely on Jump to gain deeper insights into their data, helping them design better products, accelerate developments, improve quality, and reduce waste. With its powerful visualizations, Jump enables professionals to explore their data more deeply, uncover complex relationships, and discover insights they didn't expect. If you're a young professional in the consumer products industry or countless other industries, you can visit jmp.com/scishow to reap the benefits of visual statistics for yourself and get a 30-day free trial. Finally, there's ground current, which is where you can get struck by lightning without actually getting struck by lightning. This is what you really need to be careful of. Remember that second dead giraffe? She was probably killed by ground current. In fact, ground current can be blamed for a lot of animal death, including some really extreme examples. Like in 2016, when 323 reindeer were killed in a lightning storm in Norway. Or in 2021, when about 550 sheep were found dead after a thunderstorm in the country of Georgia. Sheep really seem to be the record setters here. In 1918, the ground current generated by just 2 bolts of lightning managed to kill 654 sheep on Mill Canyon Peak, Utah. And as I mentioned in the beginning, 835 sheep were killed by a single bolt of lightning in Pine Canyon, Utah in 1939. According to one report, 15 additional sheep were struck and survived, as did the human tending to them, who was inside a tent at the time and got knocked unconscious. Speaking of which, in humans, ground current accounts for roughly half of all lightning deaths and injuries. It's really dangerous because it's caused by lightning deciding to move along the surface of the earth after a strike and jumping back up into someone standing on the ground. Human and animal bodies are generally more conductive than soil, and the more legs you have on the ground and the farther apart they are, the worse it's going to be for you. That's because the farther apart your legs are, the greater the voltage difference between them. And it's the voltage that drives a current through a circuit. In other words, by having more than one leg, you've basically turned your entire body into a wire and increased the chance that the current decides to move up one leg into your torso, where most of your important bits are, before going back down into the ground. The more legs you have, the more ways that can happen, and the farther apart those legs, the worse it'll feel. As bipeds, we humans can do something pretty simple to reduce our risk. Pretend we only have one leg by putting both as close together as possible. It's easier than trying to stand on one leg for a whole thunderstorm, anyway. But if you're not human, like if you're a giraffe watching this video to learn how you can avoid being struck by lightning, first off, congratulations for learning English. But second, I'd suggest maybe moving away from your friends to only somewhat near something taller than you. And you can always just lie down, preferably on a rubber mat.